On September 26, the DART spacecraft was 7 million miles from Earth, en route to make its terminal run against the moonlet Dimorphos. DART collided head-on with Dimorphos, fundamentally deforming the asteroid and changing its orbit. The final image it sent back to the Earth was that of a rock-strewn field. What was a staple of science fiction fare was successfully recreated in real life in a historic mission. James Webb as well as Hubble shot the iconic moment in our planet's history. For the first time in more than 60 years of space exploration, humanity had not just explored the solar system, but also rearranged it. Well, kind of. Orbit. Beyond the blue. The small moonlet called Dimorphos and the asteroid Didymos posed absolutely no threat to Earth. Most asteroids on the risk list are not cause for immediate concern. But when a huge bolide exploded in the atmosphere over Russia in 2013, blowing out thousands of windows in the city of Chelyabinsk, it was totally unseen by scientists, until it was already a fireball blazing above the surface of Earth. We need to be prepared, should an Armageddon-style scenario seem even remotely likely. And that is NASA's reason to build a $300 million spacecraft. While the risk of any known potentially dangerous object hitting Earth is minuscule, that doesn't mean that there is absolutely zero risk. DART is just our first step toward practically expanding the Planetary Defense Wing of NASA, which is tasked with identifying and mitigating near-Earth objects which have a possibility of hitting Earth. While Dimorphos was harmless, the plan was to change its orbital velocity, which in turn would slightly alter the trajectory of Didymos, not because it's dangerous to Earth, but because it could be a skill that NASA has to use one day to nudge a huge potentially hazardous asteroid, like, possibly, the dreaded Apophis, and a few others. Asteroid 2022 KL8, which was discovered earlier this year and is set to make a close pass by Earth in the year 2111. It could be a very interesting object for astronomers to study or for future astronauts to even visit. There's also the car-sized asteroid 2009 TB, which has a 1 in 350,000 chance of smacking into Earth in 2022. Officially, the second riskiest asteroid on the list, based upon a combination of its size and likelihood of impact, is asteroid 1979 XB, a monster of a rock about a half mile across. And then there's the near-Earth and potentially hazardous asteroid with a 2.7% chance of hitting Earth. The highest on the list. 99942 Apophis. The asteroid was previously thought to be at risk of impacting Earth in 7 years, on 13 April 2029. However, NASA ruled out the possibility of these impacts earlier this year, but not entirely. Which means that we are safe, for now. NASA JPL has considerable reason to believe that the asteroid will be making a dangerously close approach after 100 years, and also will be on an Earth-resonant path in 2060 and 2068. It will still be approaching in 2029. It will be as close as Venus is to Earth and will provide a massive opportunity to study it, before its riskiest approach 100 years in the future. Apophis is enormous. And with a name like that, it is scary enough as is. Discovered in 2005, it's reckoned to be about 370 meters in diameter. That's about as tall as the Empire State Building in Manhattan, New York. It's reckoned that an asteroid as big as that, coming as close to Earth as Apophis will, is a 1-in-1,000-years event. Apophis isn't going to strike our planet on April 13, 2029, but scientists think that the effect on it of the close pass could alter its trajectory, and dangerously so. This Earth swing by could put the rock on an Earth resonant impact trajectory that comes in 2060 or 2068. NASA doubts that, but given that Apophis just might cause a catastrophe in 40 years, scientists intend to study the asteroid when it makes its closest approach in 2029. After all, if there's even a small chance that Apophis could be nudged onto an Earth-bound trajectory, post its 2029 approach, that sees it collide with Earth in 2068, then we'd better know what it's made of, and exactly how best to deflect or disrupt it onto a new trajectory. Their plan is quite a risky one. Either way, the Apophis 2029 PDM would be an intriguing follow-up mission to the DART. It's believed that NASA will be using its OSIRIS-REx mission to visit Apophis during its close approach to Earth in 2029. The OSIRIS-REx spacecraft is already an experienced candidate in visiting huge asteroids and studying them for us. In 2020, it briefly touched asteroid Bennu, from where it collected samples of dust and pebbles. To be able to observe Apophis and the changes that may be induced by its close approach to Earth, the spacecraft would have to rendezvous with Apophis several months in advance. The main mission objectives for the Apophis 2029 mission would be to make impact risk assessments, determine its physical properties and interior structure, and map its entire surface before and after the Earth flyby. It will also be an unmissable opportunity for astronomers and planetary scientists to get a close-up view of a true relic of our solar system's formation. This is why the DART mission was so important for NASA and the world. There are plenty of asteroids and other space rocks out there that we haven't yet discovered or started tracking. So, the data gained from DART could literally come in handy at just about any moment. The observations and more conducted by numerous other astronomers will begin to paint a more detailed picture of the DART impact in coming weeks, including how much material the asteroid ejected and how much of it is made up of larger chunks versus fine dust. We're embarking on a new era of humankind, an era in which we potentially have the capability to protect ourselves from something like a dangerous, hazardous asteroid impact. What an amazing thing, we've never had that capability before, said Dr. Laurie Glaze, the director of planetary science at NASA. The hope is all this will also better inform any future efforts to divert more threatening space rocks that attempt to call on Earth without an invitation, but what do I know? Orbit. Beyond the blue.